as you say, and that, you know, what PJ was talking about, in that whole protocol, here, you know, opportunity to do something different every year, because it's always there. So here we are in June, it's raining today. No, well, it's summer, we need sunshine. What is going to happen with the fruit? So in a couple of years, when after we get the O2N fruit, I guess just a 10 fruit, what are we going to do with this? What's it going to be like? I mean, what is the future going to hold for this grape? Does it have a chance to be DRX, or is it going to be different plants? So not even having an idea without even having a picture, it's a great mystery.
Well, and that's a really good point that we mentioned. You're not just messing around. You have this clear goal in mind of what you're trying to achieve. You know, you're basically eliminating the variables and just coming it down until you reach exactly what you're trying to do. And that's what this DRX is all about. It's the best barrels of each block of wine that we made that year. So how are you thinking that other one's stacking up against O2?
I think the O2 has almost more creamier, softer tannins. It is jello from start to finish.
Yeah.
Still has the complexity, but still boom, simple finish. It doesn't linger too long. It makes you go, woo!
This is a wow wine. You know, I think that you kind of get jaded. You get to drink this a little bit too often. Sometimes you just got to step back and go, oh, yeah. I think that this O2 is drinking exceptionally well right now. But, you know, they're just different.
You have different kind of fruit, more kind of going in. The other one, top hat, blackberries and currants. This is going to be almost a little bit more plum.
I'm glad I had that plum, for sure.
You know, because everything is just very, pretty close to minimal residual sugar, so nothing is too sweet, and it's just actually a very simple story from the mouth, but it's like every adjective that you like when you hear a story, when you watch a show, it's right there. It's the visual, it's elegant. It's only on the tongue, and it just kind of slides off. It's like both summertime, it's that water park, and just kind of go with it.
It's Cinderella.
It's Cinderella in class. Her slipper is my container.
So, like, this could be kind of interesting. If we were doing straight up flight, like I said, this would be as the DRX as well. This is a Meritage. So this is a flight of three Bordeaux blends from Deerfield year after year. And so the main difference though is that this one is going to reflect a specific terroir, a specific grape growing region. Like, I mean, and it can get down to couple hundred feet, you know, in either direction, that constitutes that specific block of grapes. That's where those specific flavors come from. And it really is phenomenal how much the microclimates change, you know, just from here to our neighbors across the way. So this is kind of an interesting experiment in trying to get five varietals from one vineyard and making a blend out of that. So it is not an exact comparison between all three wines, but we'll see how it goes there.
And also O3, like everything that we've made from 2003, phenomenal. It just, everything was right. Sun, no droughts, enough water, there was no fires, no crazy insects, Godzilla wasn't storming through and destroying everything. Just everything came out perfect. So with this one, with that Meritage from the trail in the Yountville area. So again, you can have Cab as the main source, about 47%. You have some Cab Franc, and this time Petit Verdot, overlaps the Malbec, which then you have Merlot and last.
Yeah, you know, 04 was a merger with Godzilla.
Yes, But what we did, because we just took the remains, see what we got, and we made some killer ones with that. So that was more like an experimental psychedelic.
And that is just like so what I'm trying to get out of this flight that we're doing today, which is just 2003, stellar year. But 2002, this wine is still superb. You know, it's like we're working with what we got and making the best anyway. You know?
And especially for these older Bordeaux varietals, you know, we'll keep them longer in the barrel. I mean, things don't pretty much happen until after about usually 2.5 years. And then usually that's when the blends start kind of coming around. And we can blend them anywhere from like just months to have them blended for a year before we pop into a bottle.
And what's our current release on the DRX? This 02?
Yeah. We did bottle the 05, and last year when we put it in the bottle, it was amazing. Like, if there's a way we can sell like these little wooden barrels and just have people drink from there instead of these little bottle things, amazing. But of course, it has to go through the bottle shock and go through our time a little bit before it can do that wizard thing again.
But I mean, we don't release these wines until we feel that they're ready. So 02 is our current release right now. And yeah, the process, that the time that the wine has to mature. Because like you just were saying, we make the wine separately, the different varietals separately, and then those age in barrels separately for a couple of years before we blend them, and then they sit in the barrel for a little while longer together, just so everything kind of mingles and comes together, and then it gets bottled and it still sits in the bottle for another couple of years until we feel like, oh, it's perfect, it's drinking right, just now. So.
Okay, so let's see, with this Meritage, you get more of the spice kind of popping up. You get black pepper, white pepper, almost a little bit of molasses.
Definitely more spice.
And this, when you drink it, it is drinking a velvet Elvis. It's those paintings that you saw, like in the 80s, and you touch it, and it just kind of glides down one way. It's just.
Oh, just keep talking.
You feel it, baby. You know, it's like that couch where you're just kind of easing down a little bit. There's no reason to sit up straight. It is just enjoying.
So what's the verdict then, man? A 1, a 2, a 3, personal preference?
Personal preference, I'm taking that 02. I think that's pretty killer. I don't know, that elegance of 01 definitely has a place in the back of my tongue, and then, still can't go wrong with the Elvis. So I love them all the same. It's just, if I had to choose, and today, June 4th, rainy, probably crack open up an 02 DRX.
All right, yeah, I mean, for me, pretty much leads to 02. I think it's kind of a photo finish between the 02 and the 03 right now. But it's like choosing between your children. It's always impossible to ask. Mm-hmm. Well, Ben, thank you for coming on the show. It's a pleasure having you.
Awesome. Thank you for coming by the cave.
I'm sure I'll visit you soon. All right, we'll see you guys next week on Cellar Rat TV.
Cheers, bitches.